Sing a bit, 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 sing a bit So the bank will come to build a united front here in Australia. to fight the oppressors, to fight the colonizers with you. So united to stand and never to be divided. And so we will continue to wage our struggle, continue to build our Pan-Africanist revolutionary movement. We say he's the land.
Freedom of death.
I just had a message from the youth of today, and the youth of today gave me a task that before I started speaking, I must say the following. Viva Christmas, God, viva!
Viva!
Viva Christmas, God, viva!
Viva!
Viva outsourcing, God, viva!
Viva!
Viva Christmas, God, viva!
Viva!
Viva Christmas, God, viva!
Viva!
Viva the Buddhist movement, viva!
Viva!
Happy the Home Savannahs of our food coming!
Happy!
Thank you very much. My name that was fought by the generation of the youth that fed on that fateful day still continues to this day. It is so sad that 40 years later was still stuck with the same crisis that they had to confront. It is so disappointing and so sad that 40 years later we are yet achieving what they fought for. I stand here today representing the current generation of the young people who are saying to everyone, we have discovered our mission. As Franz Fanon once alluded, that each generation shall discover its mission. The question is whether they shall fulfill it or betray it. We have discovered our mission. Our mission is nothing but to continue where the generation that fell 40 years ago left off. Our mission as the generation of the youth of today is to combat the current neoliberal onslaught that is against the African working class community. It's to combat capitalism in its all manifestations. White supremacy, sexism, neocolonialism, imperialism, in all manifestations of capitalism, we need to combat it. That is the same struggle that the generation that fed on that fateful day 40 years ago fell. It is therefore our responsibility as the current generation of the youth to take over where they left off and carry the struggle forward. It is our duty to respond that revolutionary spirit. It's our duty as the current generation of the youth to carry and sustain that particular revolution. It must be mentioned that the struggle for the liberation of the African people in Azania and in the African continent and everywhere else where the African people find themselves in has been betrayed. We will not shy away from mentioning that the struggle for liberation was aborted, if not betrayed, by those that today seek to tell us that we need to celebrate a day when people died. Celebrating a day when people died, to me, is tantamount to organizing a wedding while there is a funeral next door. It's so un-African and so inhuman. Yes. I therefore appeal to my peers, my fellow young people, that this day is so emotional. Let us not reduce it to party. Let this day not be reduced to booze, to jiving, for black coffee and many other of our parties. Let this day be utilized to inspire us to carry the struggle that has been betrayed and aborted by those that are currently in power. I therefore appeal. All of you in this house, that please support the struggle for fees to fall. It is not our struggle as the children, it is the struggle of our parents who are expected to pay for our fees. No. Of the education and the entire legacy of colonialism. Support the struggle for outsourcing to fall, because it's a struggle for deprivatization of all people's services that were privatized and were given to entrepreneurs who are today paying peanuts to the fellow African working class majority. We are committed as the youth of today. We are recommitting ourselves to the struggle for the total emancipation of Africa and its people, for the united and socialist Africa in our lifetime.
I walked over to that white man, I told him, white man, apartheid is over. in some parts here of Azania, and I ran him off of that street. Black power?
Black power.
Give me a minute, you got just a moment. Just a moment. I come here again from the United States of America. I'm happy to be back again. I've only been away for 400 years. I've only been absent for over 400 years. We lost our language, lost our religion, lost our culture, lost our God, and many of us, by the way we act, we even lost our minds from our sojourn from Africa to America. It brings tears to my eyes when I hear your songs and your chants in my native language. I don't know my native language. I was robbed of my native language, robbed of my education, robbed of who I am. But when I hear you and I hear my homeland, it brings tears to my eyes because I'm lost from my native language.
Black power.
I have the same spirit as Shaka Zulu.
born out of the womb of the oppression of white racism, white supremacy, white domination inside of the United States of America. So I want to thank Africans in America for coming to teach us. I represent to you today as I move through this. I represent to you today, yes, I represent Black Lawyers for Justice. Yes, I represent the Black Panther movement inside of America. But I also come here today to tell you that I bring you greetings from the Nation of Islam. I bring you greetings from Louis Farrakhan inside of America. I bring you greetings from the red, black, and green movement inside of America. All of our brothers and sisters, many of them who are watching us right now, from organizations inside of America, we are with you. All of the black organizations in the West, in Canada, in America, we are with you. We are with you. Inspired by the resistance struggle against the wicked, racist, apartheid governments. As students at Howard University, as students in America, we were greatly inspired by your struggle here. I knew nothing of struggle. I knew nothing of black nationalism. I knew nothing of Pan-Africanism until I came to Howard University. And at Howard University, we studied the anti-apartheid movement here in Azania, and that movement is at Bokmia, all the way in America. We studied Soweto. We studied the works of Sisulu. We studied the works of Stephen Biko. We watched you. We organized on your behalf. We protested. We demonstrated. We boycotted. We rallied around the apartheid struggle that you were fighting. We were over there fighting for you as well. And as you rose up, you bathed us in black consciousness. You bathed us in the knowledge of Africa and the struggle in Africa. We were baptized in the struggle, through your struggle. So I want to thank you. Now we are here today, as I conclude, we are here today because of the youth. We are here today because of the revolution of young people. We are here today to really say that it is young people that should be out here at the forefront of this struggle. It is young people inside of America. You watch them on TV. You see young people in America fighting police brutality in Ferguson, Missouri. You watch them on CNN. You see the young people in America rising up against police brutality, white racism, white supremacy. It is the young people. And it is the young people that will lead this struggle tomorrow. Black power.
Black power.
Black power.
Black power.
In this time, as I conclude, we must have, at the end of our convention, we must have a worldwide Pan-African movement. We must have. We have to have all black African organizations in all 144 countries all over the planet fighting on a common front, fighting against a common enemy. We must have a worldwide Pan-African movement. power from everybody that has taken that power from us. We must have the power, and we must have it now. We must have our land back, and we must have it now. We must have the land back in Missouri. We must have the land back in Zimbabwe. We must have the land back from the Cape to Cairo. The land back from Los Angeles all the way to Limpopo. We must have our land back, and we must have it now. We have to remove the uncle Toms.
Yes.
We have to remove the blood suckers.
Yeah.
We have to remove the black faces who are controlled by the white man, and they are black faces controlled remotely by white minds and a white hand. We must have real black leadership that is not trying to enrich themselves, not and corrupt leadership. We must overthrow. We must have leadership that will put the land back into the hands of the people, the resources.
We have never wanted to own the struggle, because as Skalang, this struggle started in 1652 by different people. Lots of black people have made sacrifices in advancing the cause Long Sabha way, in trying to win back the land. And therefore, Akeko amongst us would say, "Hi, he in iNgqala is struggle. The struggle represents the sum total of the sacrifices zabantu abamnyama in this country. And when we talk organizationally, Niyazi's, there were gallows at Pitori. And you know that more people who were held at the gallows were members of the PAC.
Yes, yes.
I'm not standing here to praise the PAC, but I want to put the PAC in context because Yabona, Niyakala, you get very excited, but the majority of you don't know the PAC. If the PAC became weak in the 60s and 70s, it's likely because most, they paid more than anybody else. They paid more than anybody else. But when the Black Conscious Movement came into being, they paid. They paid dearly. We are the only organization that's now AMA tried and tested leaders. As now, the Black Conscious Movement has not tried and tested leaders because those children were killed. Umthuli Kashezi was pushed in front of a train. Umkhuputsi Tiro was disemboweled by a parcel bomb. Uma Peter Mohapi was hanged. Stephen Biko was killed. We have no tried and tested leaders. The system never gave the Black Conscious Movement any chance. I'm a teacher by profession, so I'll teach. Ngoba ngiyakwazi, ngiyayazi intetha ngayo. The struggle, sabantu abamnyama, they have fought, sometimes they have lost, sometimes they have shown an unbelievable courage as they went ahead, balwela umhlaba wabo, balwela to bring back their wealth, balwela to create a condition esizonza ukuthi abantwana babo bakhule kahle. That's the struggle sethu. Asikhulume ngo-1976, and let's tell the truth. Comrade Ntsiye was right. If somebody can say we did not learn from Usobukwe, they'll be telling lies. If they say we did not learn from Mtupi, they'll be telling lies. Actually, Mtupi ni amkhulume but we're PAC. Because.
Yeah.
samlando apla. Samlando apla.
Appel,
Apela.
Apela, Marco.
Amen.
hurting me, okay?
Por viu, por viu.
Ai, I'm a discipline. Mama? Bani. Bon, I will call you later. I'm still busy. I'm in Soweto. Yo, I'm not on WhatsApp,
bruh.
I'm only available on Facebook, bruh. For now, yeah, my phone. I broke my phone last time. Ugh, depression, bruh, depression. I will call you, sure.
Yeah.
are too famous on this field. You must fall.
Thank you. Sakichimela, wakane
Viva Apla!
Salute to the right!
Yeah. Members of leaders in the party, moving around the country visiting this particular company from his her own salary.
Mama, Lord.
From her own salary. Right? Meaning that she has to decide between buying bread for the day and going to visit and check Lama John about their own conditions. It matters less what right or wrong what was done. But the passion and commitment made to enter Lama John and to keep their spirits high matters most. And to keep the faith high. So, what for us all?
Mama, wait. Mama, wait.
Africa.
Israel.
Facebook without knowing information at all.
Teach me.
In Zulu, but in Zela, Ibuzwa, Wababa.
In Jalo, Mad.
I just said one of us. So, Uzan Rubata Wabuya Lab. To read Wuti Ama Africa, they are criminals. Abasa Jane, Nabakumi, the Baba Bushodo, criminal. Africa is unacceptable. Ubuti Niti, somebody wrote and said they are serial rapists. Mfuna ukunazisa namhlanje mafika ukuthi that they became political prisoners is not because they were PAC members. Mafika verification was done. Like mafika sichilo ukuthi we went to all the prisons mafika in all the provinces zala eAzania. Sahlala phansi mafika saba interrogator PAC members were there. Even applicators were there. I had to bring a bushelana ammunitions in case. So, Papuma Glamour, and we did not do it once. There's Pindelela, Google Prisoner, and Pindelela, until we are convinced Uti Lomutu and Bella, we political prisoner. Because what I had to ask Jello, Uti, the mission at Wenza, Wupino, Barney, Fata, a concert, and eating order with Simtata as a political prisoner. And the Bobana, my Afro Boshoi, for easy, those are my first credit. That's not a lot. They are PSC members. Is my embracer, Sibena Guma workshop, as well as the friends and Emma prisons, and even Ama branches as our Vula Guma prison. So my store parent to Uti, which were Labantu, any time I put up prisons, they are just criminals. Mafika, are you for the day? Tell Uti, never respect them, Mafika, was Baluela Nina.
Jalo Mother.
And any into Mafika, what is a political prison? A political prison, Mafika. You cannot call me a political prisoner, Gosha Namsaji, or
in
2000. It doesn't work like that, Mafika. We respect Mafika as a prison for a different thing, but slam the Mafika
economy.
So if I'm a young heist man, you support him.
Injalo, man.
You
leo, man. Teach, man.
So, we follow to see you. Please. So a political prisoner in this case, as far as the APLA is concerned, the first time he cut off date was on the 10th of April 1994. For those who did whatever before then, they were accepted as political prisoners. I had to give you this history, Nyana, because social media, the community has understood. So, the reason being that EPAC, the leadership of PAC there, EAT, Kuba Charter, if Mizoti, Mizobama Africa, May 27th, 10th May, if Mizobama Africa, May 27th, April, Ama Africa went, Osagara, Labasa Seba 13, so Bazo Puma Bali, let it be the 10th of May, Seba Bona, Butina Babo Castro, Bezekai, Abu Mukai, Sebezekai. Then that was the first cut off date. Yama political prisoners. And then it was extended.